Jaggy123 talking about Ms. Romney's screaming tithing. Tithing. It's a charity. You people don't understand. You people don't know what we go through. You people have no idea about the suffering of that top 1%. Jaggy123, you know, you're hitting the issue. It's just such a disconnect. It's like right now when we start talking about this next story with Justin Elliot from ProPublica, you know, the media is going to say, well, you know, the guy's just he's just a businessman. You people don't understand. You don't understand what it takes in business. Justin, tell us this story. This is a great story. Justin, you've heard him on the show before, investigative journalist with ProPublica. This is an incredible story to me, the roots of Bain Capital in El Salvador's civil war.
Yeah, it's fascinating. I mean, the first thing about it is, I mean, this is really another area in which there's still an awful lot of unanswered questions. I mean, Bain is, you know, as we've been finding out, an incredibly private company. And one of the things that we don't know much about, but we know a little about, is where the original money came from for the original Bain Capital fund. This was about $35 million that was raised by Mitt Romney when he started Bain Capital back in the mid-80s, 1984. And we know from some public documents and also from some reporting done by the Boston Globe back in 1994 when Romney first ran for Senate that a bunch of this money, about 20%, $6 or $7 million, came from wealthy families in Central America, including some families in El Salvador that were linked to some of the, or at least members of the families were linked to some of the violence in the, you know, brutal civil war there.
What was the first of all, put this in perspective for us,
sure.
Justin. This wasn't regular. This is where they were giving children rat poison to kill them. Because they didn't want to be able to, to be able to trace bullets back to the right wing hit squads. I mean, this is an ugly, ugly story. I mean,
yeah,
this wasn't just an isolated incident. Hey, you know, we shot somebody by accident. They were murdering people in an organized kind of industrial kind of way, weren't they?
Yeah, I mean, this was really one of the uglier sort of subplots of the Cold War, and people who were reading the news in the 80s probably remember hearing a lot about it. You know, you had a left-wing guerrilla movement that was fighting a right-wing military government that was backed by the United States with an awful lot of training and money and military aid. And this fighting went on for about a decade until I think the peace was brokered finally in 1992. And by the end of it, tens of thousands of people had died. And that was the context in which a lot of the wealthy families in El Salvador were you know, they were trying to get their capital out of the country and looking for other investments.
But a lot of them were the money. I mean, the point is this is just like any fascist regime. I mean, the money comes from the industrialists. The money comes from the people who want to prop up, no different than Batista in Cuba or in Chile. You know, you go all over the world. It's always the money that's propping up the fascism. I mean, the De Sola family. Look, I'm in Florida. I mean, I know what his contact was with Miami. I knew the early stories of De Sola down in the De Sola family down in Orlando De Sola down in Miami. I mean, where,
right.
he started this right-wing arena party.
Yeah.
Trained by U.S. former intelligence, in the De Sola family's name, shows up as some of the money that went in to start Bain Capital.
Right. So the most famous member of that family is Orlando De Sola, who, as I understand, is actually in prison on something unrelated right now in El Salvador. But he was a prominent member of the right wing movement, and there were allegations and strong evidence that. That he was involved in some of the violence, although he always denied it. And now Orlando De Sola himself was not a investor in Bain, but there were other members of the De Sola family who were investors in Bain. And again,
and they were weren't they business partners also? With
yeah, that's what the Boston Globe reported back in the early 90s. And the interesting thing is, back then, I mean, it shows you how much things have changed. You know, it was Mitt Romney's first run for office in 1994. He was up against Ted Kennedy, and he was doing a lot of interviews. He was much more talkative than he is now. And the Globe actually asked him about this, and he said, well, look, you know, I went down to Miami to meet these potential investors and woo them. And we were a little bit worried about connections they might have, but we actually looked into them and found that they were clean. You know, we don't have any, he didn't offer any sort of evidence for what they found, and the campaign is now not commenting on it at all. And we don't even have a full list. That I've seen, certainly, who all the original investors were.
You've asked for it. And just like everything about the black trap at Bain, you're not going to get it because it's a cover-up. They know that if they let any information out, we're going to see that. You don't have to say it, Justin. I'll say it because I followed this story a long time, too. I mean, I didn't know all the – this is, by the way, this is you did this story back in January initially, and this story was even knocked around, at least the part of the Orlando de Sola connection. This is not, look, if I'm in a courtroom and I see these different parts coming together on cross-examination, I can promise you it's going to be tied up. And the tie up here to me, what is what's important, the tie up is that some of the first money that little Mitt went after to try to build Bain Capital came from El Salvador blood money. And it's inescapable. The media doesn't have to say it. You don't have to say it. Anybody looking at these facts, it's almost impossible not to see this connection.
I think it's something, you know, that we need to, or that I would like, and you're probably right that the campaign is not going to give up any information, you know, voluntarily, but I'd like to see it further investigated. You know, the Los Angeles Times, part of the reason we're talking about it, did a story that mentioned some of this. But again, I mean, there's just so much we don't know about Bain, and you know, which is really what Mitt Romney's running on, his record there. So I think there's, I hope it's something that people ask him about directly. And another interesting aspect to this I should add is Romney himself has actually brought this up as when he's wooing Hispanic voters. He's actually said, you know, some of these families from Panama and El Salvador were my original partners in Bain, and he's kind of left it at that. He sometimes mentions that in sort of
he doesn't mention the 70,000 people left dead in El Salvador, and he doesn't mention that many of the people that had to escape El Salvador and come to the United States, it was their family members who were killed by people like the Orlando de Sola connection or the I haven't even talked about Roberto D'Aubuzon. What tell us, what are the connections with Roberto D'Aubuzon here?
Yeah, this sort of gets deeper into the de Sola family. That he was the leader who Orlando de Sola. There's evidence that he was in the inner circle, and this was the guy who was responsible for, you know, a lot of the violence in El Salvador. So again, I mean, you know, it's hard to get people to, you know, we are talking about something that happened, you know, almost 30 years ago at this point.
But it's important. But
it's important, I think, because this is, and Mitt Romney, you know, certainly did turn this initial investment of $35 million, you know, increased it by hundreds and hundreds of percentages. I think we should be asking sort of where it originally came from, and hopefully at some point in the campaign we'll get more detail on
that. Well, one thing for sure, we know that somewhere around 40% of the initial investment capital came from somewhere down there, somewhere involved in El Salvador, and somehow that money came from the aristocracy that was backing in every kind of way the right fascist movement that killed so many people down there, indirectly, directly, you name it. They ought to be releasing some of this information, just like they ought to release tax returns, just like they ought to release information about their overseas scam money. They ought to release some of this information. The guy's running for president. And you know what's more important, Justin? There ought to be people more than just you and a handful of other people in the media asking these damn questions.
If the media wasn't dead. Give it some time.
It's only been a decade, two decades. But, you know, the truth is mainstream media is dead. Thank you for being out there, Justin Elliot, ProPublica. Great material.
This program to bring you a special news bulletin.
This is the Ed Schultz Show.